We're going to talk about how you can strengthen your brand and use a branding strategy for a competitive advantage. And then also, a big question comes up, when do you revitalize a brand? As family businesses, you've been in business for a while, and what are some of the trigger points that should indicate to you that your brand may need to be refreshed? So the first question is why does branding even matter? Why would you take on a branding strategy? Well, when you have gone through the process of branding, your brand promise declares who you are to your customers and your consumers. It makes it very clear. It's like a shortcut so that they understand who you are compared to your competitors. It gives clarity and cohesion. So it kind of makes everything that you do intuitively, it makes it very intentional. So you have a brand platform that you're coming from. And that gives you the ability then to actually drill that down into your employees. We're going to talk about how critical employees are in branding in just a bit. It gives you differentiation and positioning. Differentiation is really how you're different related to your competitors, and positioning is who you are in relation to them. It also helps to lower sales resistance. Now, this is a key point in B2B selling, more so than B2C selling. But when you have a really great B2B brand that's very clear, very intentional, positioned very well, it lowers sales resistance. It helps the sales cycle speed up. And it also creates trust and relationship because you have consistency and you have cohesion. What your brand promises, you deliver on. That creates trust and relationship. Branding also helps you reflect your pricing strategy. So if you are a premier brand, for example, that should show up in your pricing strategy and your price points as well. It creates your reputation, and it does add value to the bottom line. Not only to the bottom line, but it should be showing up on your balance sheet as well. And the CPAs in the room, raise your hands. Yes, you guys, you can get it on the balance sheet. So see them if you don't have your brand value on the balance sheet. A lot of people don't understand exactly where branding falls into the entire marketing communications process. So we use this branding pyramid as a way of explaining that to people. So marketing is really foundational within your company. A lot of companies have, almost all of you will have a marketing department. But marketing is not just a department in your company, it's a function that goes throughout everything you do within your company. We always talk about the five P's, product, price, placement, people, and promotion. And as you develop your brand, you want to have a strategy on each of those five P's. So Walmart's strategy on price is pretty easy to figure out, right? Low price every day. But it's really important that price be part of your brand because it's going to help with your positioning. Part of that process is to do a SWOT analysis. You're probably all familiar with that. And then that leads into your positioning and your new products. Should be a part of that. So marketing is really foundational. It is something that is strategic. Your marketing strategy should not be changing all of the time. You should be taking on a strategy and then playing that out. And if you're just starting with branding, you're not going to see the real results until maybe 18 months, maybe 2 years. This is not something that is a quick fix. It takes a lot of time, effort, and intention to pull a really good brand off. And so we have marketing as a foundation, and then branding actually sits on top of that. And let me tell you a story that really illustrates that well. You are all familiar with Aflac. But Aflac at one time was like a lot of healthcare insurance companies. They were spending about $45 million a year in these feel-good, you know, kind of commercials. But they only had a 2% awareness level with their buyers. And so, you know, any good CEO would look at that and say, well, we're not getting the return on investment for that. And so they went through a process of determining how they were going to create a brand for their company. And they came up with the duck, They tested the duck. 50% of the people hated it. 50% of the people loved it. So what do you do with that data point, right? But they were very courageous and went forward with it. On New Year's Eve 1997, I believe it was when they ran the first duck commercial. And within a week after that commercial ran, they had more hits on their website in that week than they did the prior year in total. Now, if they had only run that commercial once, would we know the duck as we know him now? No, they used repetition and frequency, which is a foundation of good branding. But within 3 years of using the duck as their brand, they went from 2% awareness level to 97% awareness level. And that's fabulous from a brand perspective, but what really matters is their growth went into double digits, and where their salespeople used to have tremendous sales resistance to calling and getting appointments, they now were welcomed in. And the salespeople said when they would call and say they were from Aflac, people would start, you know, quacking back to them. So it became a really fun thing. So what happened with Aflac was they created a brand that sat on top of their marketing foundation. If you look at their marketing foundation, they did not change their product lines. They did not change their pricing structure. They did not change how they went to market, their people. They did not change their people. But they created this brand on top of what was already a strong marketing foundation. Now, am I going to suggest to you today that everybody take on the equivalent of the duck? Well, no, there are other ways to do it, but the duck is just a symbol of how you can do that very effectively. So when we look at branding, it sits on top of marketing. You need that strong marketing foundation. And then going up the pyramid, once you have your brand in order, that's when you begin to communicate it. Now, we think that you need to do branding inside before you go outside. And so you need to go through an entire program with your employees so that they are fully on board, so that they are champions of the brand before you take the brand externally. And then all of that drives to the very top, which is selling at the top of the pyramid, because at the end of the day, what do you say to your people, or what does your boss say to you? How much did we sell today? How much did we sell this week, this quarter, this year? Because all of this effort is really designed to drive up to the selling point. So what happens is marketing is very foundational. Branding is presentational. Marketing is intellectual. It's very rational. Branding, on the other hand, is experiential. It's emotional. I mean, is there anything logical about the duck? No, it's all about experience. Marketing is about who you are, what it is that you sell, the nuts and bolts of your products. And branding is really how you present that to your market. Marketing is really what we would consider kind of the brain, the skeleton of your company, where branding is your face to the world, or you could say your heart and soul. Marketing is about how you are different at the core. What is your true differentiation? And branding is about how you come across differently. What is your unique look? So the branding definition that we use is that a brand is a product or service with a unique mark, symbol, or logo. It has a defined sense of attributes and characteristics, and it creates a unique experience for the consumer and the user. The important things here is that a brand is a product or service. Initially we thought years ago that branding was really just about products. And it's really moved beyond that into services. And really, as you look at our world today, the biggest brands are almost celebrity brands. And you know that when a celebrity has become a brand is when, you know, there's one name. You only need one name. It's Madonna. Lady Gaga, she gets two, but that's really a title. And some would even say that the Pope is a brand, which is kind of a unique and interesting idea. But a brand also has a unique mark, symbol, or logo. So it does have that visual aspect to it that's important, but a brand is not just a logo. It is way more than that. A brand has a defined set of attributes and characteristics. And those unique attributes and characteristics create a unique experience for the consumer and the user. And this is where the crux of a brand is. All of the 100 things that you do right to create a right brand actually result in an experience, and it is that experience that is truly the heart and soul of the brand. It is that experience that really counts.